Welcome to Conspiracy Talk. Hashtag exposure. Journey with us and walk with us to expose all the conspiracies, all the hidden secrets, world domination, martial law, Antichrist on earth. Open your third eye. This is exposure. Welcome to the show, man. This is Hashtag Exposure, and I'm your host, Science. Welcome to the show, everybody, man. Tonight, we're doing something special, something out the box. This is Conspiracy Talk, so we talk about all things. So tonight, we're talking about the flat earth. Is there a flat earth? Can we expose that? Can we do research? Do we have the evidence showing that it is or that it ain't? Well, tonight, I do. I got credible evidence that there is a flat earth, and I got credible evidence that it's not a flat earth. So it's going to work both ways for us tonight. Excuse me. Also, I got a couple of updates as far as, you know, what's happening September the 23rd at CERN. If you haven't researched CERN yet, make sure you go check that out. It's a facility in Geneva that's planning on powering up so they can go to other dimensions, open up wormholes and other things like that. I got an update on Jade Helm, the military exercise that's been going on around the United States, mostly in Texas and California. I got updates on that. Excuse me. And I also got updates on the Illuminati. So y'all just sit back, open y'all third eye, and enjoy the show. New Nation Radio.
Look out, be left.
Yeah, man. Welcome back to the show. That was Kevin Gates, man. That's somebody else who they say sold his soul to the Illuminati or to the elite. And an update on that, man, you just got to know that these people are not a part of the Illuminati, man. They are basically tools of the Illuminati to control the masses, all right? But that's what it is. But right now we're talking about the flat earth. And is there a flat earth? Okay, so if I was to say it is, where can I go and verify a little something? Okay, so let's go to the Bible real fast. It say that God has firmaments beneath the ocean, and he have those that are in the heavens, meaning that we can't go a certain height in the sky, we can't go a certain height or depth below sea level or the earth. You understand me? So if we go by what the Bible's saying, then it's firmaments. You know, in order to have a flat earth, you'll have to have certain aspects or certain things going on that they have to be hiding from us. So I got a credible clip right here I want to play for y'all. And y'all sit back and listen. New Nation Radio, man. Let's expose this shit.
This is a Reader's Digest version containing many of the interesting parts of the Flat Earth theory. For those who have already started seeing things with new eyes, it will be mostly a recap, but there could be a few new angles you haven't looked at. For the rest of you who are new to this, the first question is invariably, is this a joke? Because it's a joke, right? And that's where we start, because it's one of our two basic childhood facts. 1 + 1 = 2, and the Earth is a globe. We're taught this before almost everything else, and that right there should give you a clue on how serious this secret is. But for those who have forgotten their history, here's the modified Men in Black version. For the first 4,000 years of our civilization, we believe that the Earth was a flattish disk surrounded by a solid dome barrier called the firmament. All of the five major religions had their own version of this, and the churches enforced the belief. Then, around 1514, a man named Copernicus created a new model of the world. He stated that if the Earth was spinning around 1,100 miles an hour and circling the sun at 60,000 miles an hour, the world was then round. And while the math more or less worked, there was a problem. It was 1500, and the technology to prove such a theory wasn't there. The first balloon to carry people wasn't invented until 1760. Sailboats were the only travel over water, and the fastest thing on land was a horse. But the new worldview was promoted and took hold. The religions adapted to handle the new reality, and life moved on. More importantly, the globe model was quickly introduced into the education systems. Over the next 500 years, the challenges to this model faded, to the point where the globe was accepted as universally as physical laws such as gravity. Read that again if you didn't absorb it. For 20 generations, people believed that the Earth was round because there was a globe in every classroom they sat in. There was no proof. Hundreds of years went by, and still, civilization had no way of proving the theory. Planes were invented around 1900, but until 1957, nothing could go high enough to give a true perspective of where we lived. And that's when everything got strange. The United States and Russia both sent up rockets high enough to take decent pictures, and what they saw scared them a great deal. How do we know they were extremely concerned about the sky? Because the US and Russia immediately started firing nuclear weapons straight up, and they kept firing for the next 4 years. A few things to keep in mind here. First, this was now 1958. Nuclear weapons were very expensive and hard to come by. These also weren't those nominal yield 20 kiloton toys we used on Hiroshima. This was high kiloton to low megaton, and we couldn't get them up fast enough. And the strangeness continued in other places. In 1959, only a year into the atmosphere bombardment, 10 nations, including the United States, made Antarctica off-limits to any colonization. A treaty was put in place, and to this day remains intact. Over 50 nations now have signed off on this treaty. Do Do you know any treaty that has lasted that long between all industrialized nations? Moreover, do you know any piece of real estate in the world that is owned by no one? You would think at the very least one of the large oil companies would use their huge financial resources to explore this region, and yet they don't even petition the idea. The short version of the discovery is this. By 1958, the military had discovered the very solid upper and outer edges of our world, and had to create a way to put up do not enter signs without looking obvious. It was tricky, but if there is one thing I have learned about the authority, it's that nothing is left to chance. Most of the work had already been done for them, so their job was primarily in the details. The sky part of the dome was much higher than commercial air traffic, so the only thing they had to worry about there was the space program, which was immediately militarized. The outer border had the natural benefit of not only an extensive ocean, but a scaling decrease in temperature and a steady increase in iceberg frequency to discourage ships, all leading to a permanently frozen landmass that could not be used for any form of agriculture. This ocean and ice layout had worked well for thousands of years because the technology of the current civilization didn't evolve quickly. Sailors avoided cold weather seas whenever possible, and oxygen levels get low enough to harm people, even on high mountains. The brilliance of the design comes in the simple fact that human males are corrupted by power. Corruption so total, in fact, that they would rather hide the world itself rather than risk their power on it. You could theorize that kings and popes were told of the world a long time ago. Maybe an ancient scroll or book. Perhaps an interdimensional being told the tale of what the world looked like. But this was all but dismissed, because even the most powerful leaders of the day couldn't reach the borders. And if they couldn't, what chance did the general public have? It's one thing to be told of the giant impenetrable dome, but it's a whole different animal when you finally stand right next to it. Then the tough decisions have to be made. Do we keep the secret? And how far are we willing to go to keep the status quo? Once they decided to keep the secret, no expense was spared. The rapid progression of rocketry science had to be addressed quickly, and so the moon missions were created. Matt from the NASA channel was right in his thinking that you needed the moon mission event to stage a picture of the Earth from deep orbit, and that couldn't be more true. Establishing NASA as the frontrunner of space exploration also diverted people who would have otherwise created their own space companies for profit. The best engineers, technicians, and pilots were recruited to the NASA space program. Once there, they were compartmentalized on a need-to-know basis. The astronauts know of the deception and are sworn to secrecy under the penalty of whatever motivates them. Private space programs are discouraged, sabotaged, or absorbed into the NASA fold. Private sector spacecraft are just not going to be allowed for several reasons. The most obvious is the collision with the dome itself. The telemetry data from such a mission would show an impact failure at a certain altitude, and if repeated, would raise questions NASA just isn't prepared to answer. There are three perpetual questions about our world that can't be eliminated, but avoided at all costs. These are the questions you should ask yourself and others if this protective layer is going to be lifted. I'd like to preface this with a thank you to Max Malone, a conspiracy hardcore who has a knack for boiling down debates to a single paragraph whenever possible. It was he who said, "After over 50 years and thousands of hours of space travel footage, both by NASA and other countries, there is no exterior shot where the astronaut completes the simple act of panning the camera 180 degrees, let alone a full 360-degree sweep. This has never happened on any moon mission, exterior space station, nothing, ever. Statistics will tell you that this would have already happened by accident years ago, but it hasn't, and it won't. This is because of the rule they cannot break, the same rule that applies to television set shows that never show the fourth wall. Why? Because there is no fourth wall. Number 2. When you search online for pictures of the Earth from space, 95% of what you will see is a collection of artificial composite shots. In 2000, when I did this search, there was exactly one picture by NASA showing the bottom part of Africa and Antarctica. Now that picture is hidden within hundreds of simulated images. There are HD cameras everywhere, and no one is taking a shot of the Earth, because you can't get enough altitude to do it. Number 3. The commercial air travel routes for the Southern Hemisphere are wrong. This is an easy thing you can check out in 60 seconds. Take a map reading of the distance between anywhere near Australia and anywhere in South America. It's a straight shot across the South Pacific. Now find your favorite travel site and try to get there nonstop. See what happens. The routes start turning ridiculous. I used to business travel for years, and I've never seen anything like it. It's the one thing in the general public world they can't hide, the actual distance between these two places. On a round world, the flight is easy, just a straight shot across an ocean. But on a flat world, it becomes the greatest distance between two points. There are no shortcuts, so they distract you with multiple connections and layovers. It's only blind luck that the United States was in the Northern Hemisphere, otherwise the increased traffic would have raised eyebrows by now. I know. It's madness. It's lunacy. There are people who will tell you straight to your face that all the leaders of the world are lizards, and yet these people laugh out loud when you say the words flat earth. I was, and still am, a huge conspiracy guy. I literally ran out of new tin hat topics to research, and I still wouldn't look at this one without embarrassment. But every time I glanced at it, there was something unresolved. And once I saw the near perfection of the whole plan, I was hooked. Do your own homework. Ask the questions. Get past the possibility and see if you can move into an even bigger picture. Like who built the dome and why? That's where it starts to get really interesting, and things start opening up. I know I said years ago that the greater good was something that should be preserved, that JFK, Pearl Harbor, and 9/11 were inevitable. I still believe it, and I understand the decisions. The globe illusion, however, has run its course over the last 500 years. It's time to start again. If that means we end up getting the attention of who or what created this place and force the reset of the world, is that such a bad thing? I've put some links in the description that you might want to check out, like the current map projections used by the USGS, the United Nations logo, the Flat Earth Society, high-altitude nuclear tests, the Antarctica Treaty, among others.
In your face, all over the place.
We're online 24/7. 24/7.
You're listening to the hottest internet station.
Boomish Radio. We is radio.
It's your girl Coco. This is Sister Girl Show. We back at it. We in the building. I got science on the ones and twos.
What's
this
up,
morning.
Everybody? Wake y'all asses up.
Rock for you one more time. Check that.
Blue Nation Radio, man. Straight out of Galveston County, man. They ain't playing no games. They buzzing in the street. Y'all want y'all music play, man. Hit up New Nation, man.
Yeah, everybody.
Man, they hear them. So, man, y'all get back to music.
You are listening to New Nation Radio, NOD.
New Nation Radio, we is radio.
Everybody, this shit here for everybody, everybody. Hey, I'm right back, y'all. I said this shit here for everybody, everybody. All hustle, everybody, everybody. Hey. Everybody wanna be a dope boy. Everybody wanna be a coke boy. Everybody got a job. Everybody get money. Everybody say they from the hood. Everybody real, but they not, boy. Every bitch say that she a bad bitch. Everybody on Instagram looking like they mad rich, but they not. Everybody say they started from the bottom, now they at the top. Go. Everybody say they got haters, everybody got paper. I guess ain't nobody broke. But who is me to talk about the next nigga out here flex when I did it before? And who is you to talk about this Will Bang Man?
a nigga in it with the top down. Boy, you sound like a hater on the front line. I'ma hit the block for you one more time. Everybody got something to say, everybody wanna hate. If you ask me, every bitch gay. In the club dancing on the friend trying to pretend. When you know you go both ways, every nigga think that shit cool. Don't you be fooled, you should bring your friend home with you. Tell you eat a pussy, then you can't be mad. Cause you shouldn't have gave me the wrong picture. Everybody wanna be a dope boy. Everybody wanna be a coke boy. Everybody got a job. Everybody get money. Everybody said it from the hood. Everybody real, but they not, boy. Every bitch say that she a bad bitch. Everybody on Instagram looking like they mad rich, but they not. Everybody said they started from the bottom, now they hit the top. Everybody fucking everybody, bitch. Everybody with the shit. That's life. And then nigga tryna fuck the next nigga bitch, not knowing his bitch is the next nigga bitch. Rose gon' roll it as a check on my wrist. Oh, I'm about to blow a check in it, bitch. Truth be told, I don't even drink. But I'm tryna turn up for a bitch. I know a lot of nobodies wanna be somebody. Yeah. Plug on the way, that's a new Bugatti. Yeah. 25 bands, and fucked up fox. Yeah. CMGE nigga, that's everybody. Nope. Nobody wanna be lame. Know a lot of nobodies, but won't say nobody name. Nobody snatch my chain. True screen nigga, I ain't in nobody lane. Everybody wanna be a dope boy. Everybody wanna be a coke boy. Everybody got a job. Everybody get money. Everybody said it from the hood. Everybody real, but they not, boy. Every bitch say that she a bad bitch. Everybody on Instagram looking like they mad rich, but they not. Everybody said they started from the bottom, now they hit the top. I think this shit here for everybody. Everybody. This shit here for everybody. Everybody. I said this shit here for everybody. Everybody. Yeah. Everybody. Everybody. Everybody going to the mall, buying designer. Niggas got $100 Lambo, Hermes belt on some DG jeans. Child support looking high and low to find them. Couple niggas ballin' in the club, poppin' bottle bamboo. But if a nigga wanna know the truth, that still owe the plug. Check. And they rent his ass coupe. Check. And his watch ain't real. Check. And his chain ain't too. Damn. Shorty got a mean some followers, a mean some problems. But she a different person on the gram. Meet her in person, you like, where all the purse? Out your head, head color, shorty, you ain't got nail. Everybody need to be themselves. Everybody famous, ain't no random people left. Everybody smoking no cool. If you smoking regular, you know you gotta smoke by yourself. Everybody wanna be a dope boy. Everybody wanna be a coke boy. Everybody got a chopper. Everybody get money. Everybody said it from the hood. Everybody real, but they not, boy. Every bitch say that she a bad bitch. Everybody on Instagram looking like they mad rich, but they not. Everybody said it started from the bottom, now they hit the top. Cause this shit here for everybody, everybody. Nigga, I got money I put on everybody, everybody. Keep one in the head, cause I don't trust nobody, nobody. I'ma put it out and let it ride. I'ma hit everybody, everybody. I swear you can get it, pussy nigga. That's what everybody wanna be a dope boy. Everybody wanna be a coke boy. Everybody got a job. Everybody get money. Everybody said it from the hood. Everybody real, but they not, boy. Every bitch say that she a bad bitch. Everybody on Instagram looking like they mad rich, but they not. Everybody said it started from the bottom, now they hit the top. I said this shit here for everybody, everybody.
Welcome back to Hashtag Exposure. It's your host, Science Man. So, y'all heard credible evidence from the clip earlier, man, saying that, you know, there's a couple of things that they don't let us do. You know, they don't let people rent, own or, you know, do anything in Antarctica, and that's supposed to be the top of the world. Certain things they don't want you to see. So, what I'm going to say, like I always say on the show, is do your own investigation, man. Do I think it's a possibility that it could be a flat earth? It's a long shot, but it's a possibility, man. I mean, we should dig more into this later, you know, and we will. But just think about it, you know, NASA would be have to be fake. A lot of things that we see would have to be fabricated. And that's just what it is, you know, and it has to be like the dude said, it had to be world governments all tied in together with our government just to hide this secret. And, you know, if it is flat or oval, how the fuck did it get that way? And so we're here to expose it. And tonight we leave with a question mark on exposure. But, you know, that's what we're here for. We're here to open talk about conspiracies and things that's out there. Now, before we leave the show, I want to talk about CERN. If y'all don't know who CERN is, y'all need to go and find out. But CERN is an operation that's in Switzerland. It's a 300-mile-long atom-smashing machine. You know, they call it the Hadron Collider. You know, they smash particles together and they look for certain things that comes from these particles when they collide, you know. And so far, they found something that they call the God particle. They're looking for dark matter. They're looking for basically what happened at the Big Bang, you know what I'm saying? Like, what particle, what things happened at the Big Bang, and they're trying to recreate it. What can happen is, you know, something with that magnitude of power, it can easily, you know, rip a tear through the time-space continuum, and it can give us a black hole right here. You know, it could be the size of a dime, but that black hole will, you know, suck the whole Earth, you know, into oblivion. Or it could, you know, the gravitational pull of the machine that they're using could turn asteroids and meteors this way that's just floating by, you know. So, and, you know, they talking about powering, going full power, I think, in on the 23rd, you know. And so I got more to talk about that. And what else supposed to be happening as far as the California fault line, as far as, you know, a couple of false flag attacks, a couple of it's a lot of interesting things that's going on the front of this conspiracy world. So y'all stay tuned, all right? New Nation Radio, hashtag exposure.
Where tech will ruin, condition your brain. To know acting the fool is the vision. Caribou Lou is tradition, and the way to be true to your living is strange. We come in peace, but if you wanna be dumb and beef, a gun is summon. He wanna be young and speak. I'm a numb and speak. He's a woman, he the one, and he brungin' meat for the cunning beast. Hit a lung and sleep, dung and sleep long and deep, tongue full of gum and seed. So the technician to the sensitist, the crew, the best thing is for you to let the click see who the vetters and miss the new seekers. Wondering who the fuck is coming through these speakers. Never forget it, the medic for you. Ahead of the medicine develops soothe creatures. Yeah. You're pathetic if you're no believer, cause we all are energetic and eager. Yeah. Collide when you walk in side by side with me. Fly the skies and get high with me. On this ride you won't collide, just confide in me. Try denying me, ye dying violently. That's the way, you fakers got to pay. My people quick to spray and buck a demon till they lay. But if he breathing in my stupid, an angel by his side like Sunday. Never will it be the case because my click waited to ride when I say.
Technician! Others ain't got a clue, they coming through suspicious. Most of them want to tease. Don't come at us, you don't want the bees. It ain't nothing but real women in my circle, not them phony chicks. I don't know what I mean when I say elbow macaroni beads.
They know what I'm drinking, the ladies looking right, they know what I'm thinking. The babies even hype, the oldies be geeking. The red, the black, and white, the soldiers be seeking.
All of my people's here, taking the business, looking to equal fear. Cause I'm about to bubble and get the evil peers. Out of my life, I never wanna see you, yeah. Bitch, you ain't a technician. You don't know the pledge, but you said that you listen. Guess you misunderstood the shit, huh? Disrespect that tech trick, get done. The moral of the story is we warriors, notorious for the hordes of core, ready to roar, he is glorious. Technician number one, the mission leave him sprung with the tongue, and if you listen, it's a gun.
Technician. and calamity. That snake and bat, we flaunt it.
Unforgettable text from Edible, rapping the mid, the mo, bitch, we run it.
You gotta know that I really meant it when I said that I was gonna make the mainstream go me. Still rapping like a popping the pillow off of the killer morning, like I was taking Molly in 03. We can take anybody, we so deep. I bet that you got us on your street. I'm trying to find a spot that's big enough so all my people can meet.
Technician.
Programmed to be you. You're a slave and you don't even know it. The shit you think of ain't even your thoughts. Let's step out the box for a minute.
Yo, how do we know if God exists? How do we know it's positive? Are you the definition of an angel or the opposite? If you lost your wallet and I found it, I would not commit to stealing it. But if the tables turned, then you would pocket it. See, I've been me for so long, but I still don't know who Hobson is. How come I'm the one my teachers used to have a problem with? I show my music to different labels, they ain't too fond of it. But in the underground, I seem to get so many compliments. Say my name and it's like people get afraid and shook. But if you take a look, you'll see I'm nothing like an angry crook. I'm learning hands-on, you busy with your face and books. I'm here to benefit the world, so heaven's where we're safely put. I'm not a devil, not speaking in tongues. I just want to touch your heart, I try to reach it in songs. I'm from where a child's future's on the streets with the bums. Because it's hard to become something so unique where I'm from.
When the sun's down, nocturnal rainbows are in the air so high. It may seem so that I can't see, but the darkness provides the light for me. I don't wanna be lonely, and the moon is my only homie. But there's a higher power than show me. Instead of nocturnal rainbows,
Obama's president, so what's it represent? Just because the niggas half black don't mean he's heaven sent. You're clueless to evidence, and all the minds he's messing with. His charming smile hasn't got my ass about this death for shit. Fronting like he's truly Jesus, and all you fools believe it. The change he's making isn't good, that's just how you conceived it. It's like we all broken than ever. It's due to reasons dealing with self-beneficial plans and the movement he's with. Illuminati, or whatever the fuck they go by. They're the reason weird shit happens, and we don't know why. Why did Michael Jackson start his tour then have to go die? How did rap music go from really good to so dry? Real artists get shelved and whack ones get famous. To leave masses brainless, a smart mind is dangerous. In their eyes, there probably ain't no real shit in your playlist. You just a product of what the government has created.
When the sun's down, nocturnal rainbows are in the air so high.
We're all smart, and we know it's bad and good for us. But yet when you got offered some marijuana, you took a puff. Your brain's a fucking powerhouse. But what, that wasn't good enough? It's people like you who talk that shoulda, coulda, woulda stuff. You probably threw your life away, cause you would rather get high. With no license or car, so you bum rides to get by. Saying, I should've did this, or I shouldn't have hung with this guy. I'm broke as fuck, my rent's high. Oh, I should've realized. I ain't being cruel with these situations that I address. I more than likely could be someone you admire, yes. But it's because the blood, sweat, and all the time that I invest. We play the same game, difference is you never try your best. You don't have a skill, you set yourself up for a higher mess. I work around the clock, you slack off for lots of time to rest. Keep bullshitting till your life is gone, cause live is naturally hell. You have to work to put a smile on.
When the sun's down, nocturnal rainbows are in the air so high. It may seem so that I can't see, but the darkness provides the light for me. I don't wanna be lonely, and the moon is my only homie. But there's a higher power than show me. Instead of nocturnal rainbows, when the sun's down, nocturnal rainbows are in the air so high. It may seem so that I can't see, but the darkness provides the light for me. I don't wanna be lonely, and the moon is my only homie. If there's a higher power, then show me. Instead of nocturnal rainbows.
ass on high.
Hi, what's up? It's your girl Jada Stone. You already know to quit calling my phone, but you can check me out on NNOD, New Nation Radio, the hottest station in the country. And if that doesn't work for you, check me out on Instagram at officially_JadaStone or my website at www.jadastonemusic.com. Quit calling my phone.
Welcome back to Hashtag Exposure, y'all. And we almost out of here, man, but let me get to the juicy part. So first of all, the conspiracy that's going on for September, man, is, you know, it's a couple of things that's supposed to be happening, you know. They think it's a meteor coming. They think that the California fault line is going to finally give in, you know, the earthquake. They got this Jade Helm program, excuse me, that the Army has, where they simulating actual war and situations on our homeland. You know, they're in Texas, they're in California, Nevada, New Mexico. So, you know, in the conspiracy world, everybody trying to wonder, like, what's going on? You know, what are they planning for? You know, they never do a simulation unless they planning on, you know, going to actual battle with what they learned from the simulation. So, and just like the song we just heard, man, Obama and a lot of people of the elites, they want a certain thing to happen to the world, man, and to the government of America. You know, they would like for America to be basically a prison state. You know, if you ever heard about the One World Order, you know, they trying to bring that to pass. You know, they want that to happen. So, but regardless, let's dig a little deeper. So, if you do your research, you know that we have 4 blood moons. Pretty soon, I think, man, do your research. But if I ain't mistaken, it's September the 24th or 5th, maybe the 28th, when we have our last blood moon. I want y'all to study or go and find out about the Shemitah. You know, the 7-year period, the end of a 7-year period. I also want y'all to go find out about the Jubilee. That's the 49-year period, or 50-year period. That's like 7 Shemitahs, which is blood moons, which is, you know, some prophetic things that y'all should know about that's going on. And basically, everything in a nutshell, at the end of these Shemitahs, either the nation or the people will have a good outcome or a bad outcome, depending on the judgment of God, you know, the spirit or the creator, however you want to look at it. But not only do we have an asteroid coming, they said, not only do we have the fault line, we got CERN, we got maybe an alien invasion, we got the elite only want 500,000 people left on Earth, so they're trying to create a natural disaster. They want to wipe out America, so be prepared between September now and September next year, something major happened. A lot of things that has been prophesied in the Bible that a lot of people don't believe the Bible, but you know, the Bible is a good historical roadmap and index, and it can give us a lot of history, a lot of prophecies that, you know, I know that, you know, certain things in the Bible is propaganda, they say, and certain things are, you know, tales and all these other things, but regardless of how you look at it, things in the Bible are coming to pass, and no matter if you believe in the white Jesus or black Jesus, Yahshuwah, or, you know, Christ, no matter what you believe in, you know, it was a person, and he prophesied a lot, and the things that he prophesied, and a couple of his disciples, a couple of people in the Bible also prophesied about a couple of things, like Daniel. Y'all go read his book, The Book of Daniel. It was a lot of things that's happening now that was prophesied. Go look in the book of Revelation. That was a lot of things that's happening now to the churches and to the, you know, as far as the, you know, the false prophets and everything. Like, people thinking that Obama is the Antichrist, you know, because if Jesus was black and somebody was to come back to save the black people, per se, the black nation or the brown people or the true people, then Antichrist would have to come before him to precede him. So they're thinking that Obama is, because the way that he's selling us out as far as not, you know, going to the Justice Department and, you know, getting these killings and these strategic assassinations investigated, you know, he just, you know, turning a blind eye. You know, we had the worst time while he was in office as far as a nation, as a black nation. He did a lot of great things also, so I'm not just, you know, demonizing him, but just know that he and a lot of other people are part of an organization, the elite, that are already planning to leave America. They have underground bunkers. They have underground bunkers in other nations, in other countries. And something is going to happen, whether it is alien invasion, whether it is an asteroid coming this way. Y'all be prepared to be careful for September the 23rd, a couple of days from now, and see what happened, man. And keep y'all third eye open. Make sure y'all question everything. We will come back next week. We are discussing again the Illuminati within the music industry. We're going to dig a little deep into that. I'm going to have another guest to come through and, you know, elaborate with me. And you are listening to New Nation Radio, hashtag exposure. Yeah.
I just wanna live in God's cubicle, far away from Lucifer. Not a slave, gold chains compliment the Mueller much. Rather see me crucified, police are the crucifers. Shoot us up and dig a ditch, this ain't nothing new to us. Murders happen every day, kids on their merry way. Dying for their 21, bullets never had a name. God bless Trayvon Martin, I'm in my hoodie. Another innocent young brother who met a bully. Man, this poor world is fucked up, hard times, tough luck. Section 8 and food stamps, jobs never hired us. I'm just trying to fulfill my wish list. Don't want to be another statistic. Martin Luther King had a dream, and my niggas do too. Why Emmett Till beat and killed and gouged like a fruit? Reason why them young is untainable as a youth. And fuck the government, cause they trying to disguise truth. I send my prayers out to mankind. Not enough for graduations, but too many crimes. Pay attention as a parent, gotta peep the signs. Feeling like a book is corny, so they keep a nine. Lord bless them, got me stressing while I'm raising mine. See in the hood, people think you won't amount to nothing. Funny, I made a million out of 10 cents. Work, no one be another statistic. Preach. You in the sternum, jotted in my journal why killers are so determined. I keep a preacher, defeat the demons in every sermon. Just watch the people that meet and greet you, some aren't worthy. Some friends aren't friends, they dirty, need some detergent. So many tragedies around the world, I'm praying urgent. I'm just trying to become a blessing and serve a purpose. Nobody's perfect, I'm still sinning, just have mercy while we killing our own people. Boston, Massachusetts, bombed by some thrill seekers. It's just so tragic, many perished, I could barely witness. Don't want to be another statistic. Pray.
From the trials of the streets to the tribulations of the ghetto.
You are listening to New Nation Radio, WNOD.
New Nation Radio.